I pray that my tongue, my mouth will speak all what the Father is speaking tonight in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Dear Holy Spirit, let that new era of world leadership according to Christ's perspective break forth in a new dimension in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Yeah, because they have a cry in their spirit to see a new revolution, for a complete change, to deliver a generation in order to establish a new era of world civilization. Hallelujah. Women are sacrificing their time, sleeping in this place every day, making sure that this vision comes to its fulfillment. I want to thank all the Overcomers members under the leadership of the great man of God, Evangelist Mokole Ntuba. God bless you, sir. Put your hands together for Jesus. The wonderful, our instrumentists and all the people operating the DJ Master, and all of you, we love you because God loves you. Amen?
Amen.
Once more, the church is entering into a new era, because the prophecy that was announced about Jesus was not talking about the spiritual leader. It was talking about the governor. So the reason why the community has not been able to have its problem solved is because the answers which are supposed to produce or solve those problems are supposed to come from the true church. So this day, the last seal of that prophecy has been opened. Somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Solve men, because today you are going to find the Holy Spirit in the government. Somebody shout amen.
Amen.
So stand on your feet and let us proudly sing the national anthem of this nation, because we are taking over in the name of Jesus. Within the time we have, I want you to take your time to write what you are going to hear today. I am ready for all the religious challenges, because I owe nobody to explain anything to him. But if you will follow what we said in the morning with the spirit of repentance, you will be a blessing for yourself and your environment. I apologize if some religious activists will not understand the message, but just take it and pray the Holy Spirit will speak to you. I'm going to present to you a message caption: the Holy Spirit in government. The Holy Spirit in government. The Holy Spirit in government. I want you to repeat after me. The
Holy Spirit in government.
Again.
The Holy Spirit in government.
Again.
The Holy Spirit in government.
Again.
The Holy Spirit in government.
Hallelujah. When Jesus was about to be born, it was not a religious leader that was prophesied to come. It was a governor. Hello? Have you ever heard that somewhere? Thank God you are reading the Bible. The only reason why we cry every day of bad government is because the church has not been able to sit up like a church to produce a solution of the church to the government. Now let me show you a picture of this revelation. Suppose, is the Bible a very good document? Is the Bible a very good document?
Yes.
Suppose the Bible was the Constitution of Cameroon. Were we going to have all the corruption and injustice and all the stuff if it's fully applied? Now, is the Holy Spirit the best helper?
Yes.
And now the Holy Spirit is knocking at the door of the government. So all the crisis of the nations, beginning with Cameroon, Africa, has come to an end. In the name of Jesus. Simple. Every leadership is exposed to three major challenges. Number one, insecurity. Number two, lack of provision. Number three, lack of, or let me say, vision or direction. Every leadership. That's why when you find people gather and put chairs together and call it a church, where the pastor does not have a vision for the people, it becomes a gathering of a place of confusion. So we find in the church pastor fighting with pastor. Why? Because they don't have direction, vision. So they are fighting a common vision, which maybe is one person that's supposed to lead it. Every leadership, including all the governments, imagine, let me ask you a question. How many of you have ever been a president of a small garden or maybe a class prefect? Let me see your hand up. If you have ever heard any gathering, how do you experience the challenges in that management? Was it very easy?
No.
Suppose you are President Pobia. But we are the first people ever to open our mouth and begin to make noise of their mistakes when you cannot even manage four people. Hello?
Hi.
I know some people are going to say that man may become a CPDA man. I'm not. I am not a politician, but I am a diplomat. Because that's what the Bible says. Hello?
Hi.
Holy Ghost, Holy Spirit in government, all human crises end. When you stand in the presence of a minister and you have something to do, a minister of state, and for example, it requires you to give bribe, if that minister has the fear for the Holy Spirit, will he ask you bribe?
No.
But because he doesn't have a connection about the Holy Spirit, he will take the bribe as far as nobody is there to see it. So that is why the Holy Spirit has announced to take over, to be involved in the government, so that
Everyone without anybody will be conscious that there is somebody seeing him at any time, so he will do his work with justice.
Amen.
You see, I was crying in my spirit when they had, because I am not used to getting people too disturbed about money. But one of the things when I came here, I was in a certain church the other day, and I saw people's legs in like a grave. And the Lord was speaking, said, many of our Christians or believers or children of God here, they are highly indebted to the nose. And debt is a spirit. That's why even our countries are owing debts. And they are trying to pay it. All the natural resources cannot solve it. It's a spirit. You cannot take a physical provision to solve a spiritual problem. And the law of God to counter any spiritual act is to apply spiritual principles. Which one of them is what they are trying to harass you? You know what I was asking myself? Because me, I have a simple procedure when it concerns money with God. I do it once and for all. So I was asking myself, with all the different approach of collection, and I see money still keep on coming, why could they not just do that at once? The Lord said, their mind is 1,000,000% far from kingdom principle concerning Christ's financial policy. If you are blessed one day, I will send you that message. Hello? In the perspective of Christ, as far as money is concerned, you are not rich by what you have. Do you want to know what you are rich of? You are rich by, you have money or wealth by the, your access to it. It's not the material and the physical. I never had even $1 saved somewhere, but I have, by God's grace, spent more than 5 million CFA now to be here. So all what we ever collect in this conference cannot even pay even my transport from Lagos to, then talk about the flight from Lagos to America. But I see something on a mission, because there is a cry in my spirit according to God's mandate for the will of God to be fulfilled in this nation, in this continent, and in the world. And it must come to pass in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
So sometimes, the point is this, the principle of God cannot be bypassed. So it was just the only way to help people come out of all those things. That's why we're asking this morning. If it is possible, we would have just said, like sometimes we do, we go sometime when in my church, some days I'll just go and they'll ask me, why don't you collect offering today? I say, no, let them not bring it so that they should understand that we are not waiting for their offerings to survive. Hello? When I started the ministry established by name Christ Restoration Center with a church attached to it as House of Prayer, I never collected any offering when we started. Until one day the Lord Jesus revealed himself to me by the Spirit of God and told me clearly, he said, you are robbing the people of their blessing. Because even I myself, Jesus, collected offering. Hello? So don't go home with any attitude that they are harassing you to get your money. Suppose the Holy Spirit is ruling this country, were you going to be crying that our road were not hard? But Christ is already ruling the world in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
All we need to do is to activate the manifestation to start taking place physically. Some people will say, let me show us where it is in the Bible. The word governor does not have two meanings. Governor is governor. Somebody governing. And it actually is a state word. The word kingdom does not have two meanings. Too much religion has caused us problem. Kingdom in simple terms is a state word. A kingdom is talking about a king and a domain where he's ruling. So if we are in a kingdom, then that kingdom, the head of that kingdom, is probably a governor. Let's go to the Bible, Matthew chapter 2. Hello? How many people still love God? Matthew chapter 2, verse 6.
Some translation you may have something funny, but in King James and many others, you will hear what I'm reading. And thou, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, art not the least among the princes of Judah, for out of thee shall come a governor that shall rule my people, Israel. Hello? Who are the people of God? The people of God are all human beings created by God, period. But because of situation, some now will become children of God when they make Jesus Christ their Lord and Savior, for them to have him as a father. That is why even though you are praying for some people that, oh, this one is a very bad, he's a very bad leader, let God just kill him. God is not going to kill him, he's still there. The Bible says God, when he sends his blessing, the same rain is falling to all, both the... You know what the Holy Spirit asked me? When this crisis were going too strong, I was looking at God, but why are people still in leadership position, keeping on doing this evil and suppressing the people? And the Lord asked me a question. He said, if I release the rat according to their mistakes, then we lost the nation. Hello? Do you want to hear it? About 90% of our leaders in our administration, their hands are in blood with different covenants. So if the wrath of God is released immediately, we lost all of the positions, then we don't have any nation anymore because they have spent their money and time to be educated to lead. So God said, what I'm going to do is to allow them and use them to build up a transition. Whether they like it or not, they will be working for God. Hello?
Hi.
So that by that means I will begin to prepare a new generation of training, a new era of those who by transition I will begin to replace them. So many of you will be replacing. Hallelujah. Watch out what I'm saying. Thank God we have the videos. Maybe in about 10, 15 years' time, I'll come to some of you in your offices.
Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
It was a governor that was announced. So I asked myself, but why does this revelation already be in the church? The Lord said, because God reveals things according to dispensation. The mission of Jesus Christ when he came on earth was in two dimensions. That's why they talk about the later days. If there is, it's just two. You don't hear the middle. It's the beginning and the later. So what does that mean? We thought later days, so we are waiting one day that Jesus will come and stand and a long line and the whole place is flat. Hear what Peter said on the day of Pentecost. This is that which was prophesied by Joel, that in the last days. So on the day of Pentecost was identified to be the last days. That means the last days began since from Pentecost till now, 2,000 and something years ago. The first phase of the mission of Jesus Christ was to establish a spiritual platform, which is what we have been preaching for long and still preaching now. So that he will be able to create us to have a spiritual empowerment. The second phase was to establish a physical platform. So that is why it was difficult for the Jews to understand that he was the Messiah. Their reason was because they know by scriptures that it was a governor coming. So they were expecting him to sit on the throne even physically and lead because they were suffering. But they did not understand that according to divine mandate, a spirit being has no right to live permanently on earth. So Jesus Christ was God in the person of man. So he established a spiritual platform. He went back so that he came now again by the Holy Spirit to be in you so that now you will sit on the physical positions. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That is the second phase now of the last days. But God was not going to bring out this revelation until he discovered that the minds of the people is able to develop to a certain stage. Because if they tell you something which your mind is not close to that level of knowledge, you will abuse it. That's why they will call people false prophets. Hello?
Hi.
Tell your neighbor, we are not going to suffer anymore.
The Holy Spirit has taken over. Let me tell you another question God asked me. God asked me a question. He said, do you think the natural resources in any nations were kept there for some individual to begin to embezzle it for their selfish gain? I said, no. God's resources are to be used for God's purpose. And the people who would have used it very well should be the church of God. But do you have any access to the public treasury? Because you refuse to involve the government in your church. You are struggling every day to collect offering. That's why I know that this vision must work to the end without even somebody contributing, but it's for your own blessings. Because when the time reaches, whether they like it or not, they will sign the checks. They must. Because where they got the money for the check is not theirs. It came from the resources put by God. The ground will begin to speak. If they refuse it, they will never see it anymore. Hello? God is good. Now let's see again where that quotation of Matthew was coming from. Go to Isaiah chapter 9 verse 6. The Holy Spirit in government. The Holy Spirit in government. The Holy Spirit in government. Let me hear you shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Let me hear you shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
That's a long awaited thing you have been waiting for many years. So you should be very excited to hear it. That's the end of human suffering. That means the Lord Jesus Christ is coming. And I will show you how. I've just given you three major challenges that must face any leadership. And those challenges can never be solved by any means. That's why many have gone and entered a canker, amok. They enter all kinds of Hare Krishna and all different forms. They did all the idolatrous practices. They did all United Nations contact. It has still not solved the problems. It's not because they hate you. It's because they don't have the power to provide what you need. So that's why when things happen, the devil will come and begin to put people in confusion to go and fight. The devil is setting you to be killed so that he can get your blood. He failed last year and he will never succeed again in the name of Jesus. Isaiah chapter 9, verse 6. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given. And what? The governor. And what?
Government.
And what?
Government.
And what?
Government.
Shall be upon his
shoulders.
And his name shall be called? And the last statement they end with Prince of Peace. Can you imagine the Prince of Peace really manifesting? Were there going to be any war? Do you know why there are physical wars? Because the real war is not even those ones that they are fighting in Somalia or the strike and riot. The real war is even the one in what we call denominations and congregations. The real war is in the heart. Once the peace of Christ is not in your heart, that heart is at war. War has never manifested physically. It started in the mind. So people are looking at that. What is happening here? You are blessed in Jesus' name.
Amen.
You can never ever read the Bible to understand what I'm saying, except it is given from above. Yesterday, you see, we had a situation, we had to pray for the man of God who did not come. And like many people, those of you who happen to ever be occultists and many things, you don't need many, the things are all revealed. God is raising people who have also tried with the devil, so we know him very well. Now, I was asking God, what has happened? What are the people going to say? And the Lord said, understand the message. You were right, but I have changed the calendar. So I showed you people in the morning what it means for God to change the calendar. Amen? So just yesterday, when the man of God was supposed to leave, to come, to join in what we are doing, In the morning, suddenly the two children fell sick. And then even after that, when the case is arranged, later on, there was a kind of state of emergency in the same city where nobody moves today. Do you see God's talking? And the Lord told me that this is what is going to happen. I understood exactly the part, but the Cameroonian people do not understand the message, so I stopped him not to come. So God was able to evaluate your mindset in the first 2-3 days and discover that you are still far to understand the vision. So he wants you to understand the vision. That's why he wants the vision bearer to begin to speak by the Holy Spirit to you in the name of Jesus. And the Lord told me, said, see, every time I call a man, I choose a place. I release a mandate. And that mandate must speak and prove its evidence in that place. Then it can be extended to other places. Hello? Is it Cameroon or Nigeria? That's why the man of God did not come. God wants you to understand the vision and run with the vision and cause it manifest and prove his evidence here. Then the message can be easily accepted by other African countries. What a blessing for Cameroon to be chosen. For a reason that I can't explain why I accept God alone. I was expecting to get African map so that I can once more demonstrate to you something about what I'm saying. So, the point is, first of all, look at our religious mindset for too long. We thank God for what they have preached, but that era has ended. It's a new era. This era now must take the spiritual plus the physical, practical development and manifestation. I told you people that the word which Jesus expressed to be his real characteristic, he said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. It has also a practical meaning in physical development. It's not just a religious spiritual meaning. And here the practical meaning, the way means road. When the Holy Spirit is ruling, all roads will be tarred without any stress. Good roads will be established. The truth of God, the Bible represents it to be light. You will not have problem of light failure. And life, you can stay without food, but you can never stay without water. Everything God said in a spiritual perspective, he has a physical symbol to explain it. Do you know that if you have these three provisions in any community, that community will have the best development? So we cry every day. If we have our governments able to provide us good roads, no electricity failure, no interruption, good water, who is going to query them? They wanted to, but they could not because they don't have the power until the Holy Spirit is in it, and that's what God has decided, so that the Holy Spirit will come in it. He is the one that put the resources, so he's the one that knows how to use the resources very well. That's why when the devil come and deceive us to go and be fighting, he's just making us to die so that he can get blood. But you shall not die in Jesus' name. The Lord spoke to me, this conference we are coming to announce and make a declaration of the end of blood drinkers in the life of Africans. One civil war, the blood bank of Satan is increased like this. And all his witches and wizards, man demons, they will be celebrating. They grow old, they look young, because they are drinking blood every day. Blood which they are getting from causing confusion for people to be fighting war. The war has come to an end in Africa. Amen. They will not have bloods anymore, in the name of Jesus. Amen. The Holy Spirit in government. The Holy Spirit in government. Now, why did God give me this subject now? Because government or leadership is a spiritual, in short, the effect of your leadership is based on your spiritual strength. I can quote you an example. In Uganda, many years back, you people know about a man called Idi Amin. He's somebody who, according to their feedback, he has not even completed primary school. He became a president in a country where there are PhD holders. How could it happen? Because he was the most superior spiritually there to dominate everybody. Hello? Do you see that kind of case in Cameroon? Except you are blind to know that we have had a president called Aijo. Oh God, have mercy. Those of you who must have studied history, you knew there were people like André Marie Mira who were known like Dr. Ndele and the rest. But according to the word of God, no man comes to any position of leadership, especially at the level of nations, except God himself put him there. So why did God put even people who are? The law of the spirit says that somebody must always be on the horse. So if the prince refused to be on the horse, the servant will be. So you princes, you must get up and begin to sit on your horses so that servant will get down in the name of Jesus. If you read Ecclesiastes chapter 10 verse 7, you find it there. And a DME by this research in the school of occultism, from the feedback we have, it shows that he was at the spiritual level of occultism of 666. If you know about the feedback about the man called Adolf Hitler in history, he was not even a German by real German blood, but he used German people like tools. How was he going to do that? He was at the spiritual level in occult of 666. Hello? Do you see that leadership is spiritual? That is why whether you like to vote somebody or not, he will still win. Is somebody getting what I'm saying? I told you people about this, the handwriting of Obama, right?
Yes.
And God revealed it to me many months back when he was not even supposed, nobody thought he could even be a candidate for Democrat. And I began to tell people he must be. Because I saw it in the spirit. And later on it was confirmed by other men of God who were connected. Because in that case, God has a purpose to send a message for the black race, so he prepared it how he was going to walk. So he was identified with the spirit of God, and God has to raise Africans with the burden to begin to pray for him. Can you be surprised to hear that there were about 75% of white churches in America who were praying against him? I was there. And I can tell you that for sure, because it's one of my reasons why God took me to America. I did not go to America like people who are falling bush. I went on a mission. So the mission is defined. Hello? That's why I can come to Africa as frequent as possible, not because there's any dollar saved somewhere. But what needs to take me anywhere to do whatever is required is always in me and is activated by faith. So, guess what? It was natural, evident that he cannot win politically, except spiritually. But since that case, God was the one taking it to write a message for the black race. He has to orchestrate those who must stand in the gap for him. Now, because God saw that the people in America and many of the white churches are standing against him, because even according to the Bible, everybody is advised to pray for people. But nobody is advised by the Bible to pray against somebody, even if the person is wrong. But in this case, they were praying against Obama. It tells you that I told my wife what was going on. I said, see, you don't know what that election means. That election was a football match, black versus white. Hello? Look at the history that surrounded it to prove to you that it was a divine machinery working. The first time to have a black man to ever even stand as a candidate for a party, as a presidential candidate. The first time to have a woman forever stand as a candidate for presidency or presidential candidate for a party. The first time to have the oldest man to stand as a presidential candidate in election. Three historical events happening at the same time. Are you blind to understand that God is doing something? And that message was to tell you that this is the emergence of the black race. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The first era was over. And we thank God for what our white brothers have done in the world to lead us. Thank God for all the technologies that they have brought in development. But we don't need to produce technology now. We just need to collect it by divine reasons and use them in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
So while our government are struggling to buy technology, let them come. The Holy Spirit has a principle. And that's what will begin to happen. The Lord spoke to me and said, see, much of the resources in African nation, we know for sure that was embezzled or was exploited for building some other parts because of the wickedness of some ignorant leaders. And according to the law of God in the Spirit in the Bible, what did the Bible say is, whatever is stolen from you, when you break the yoke of the enemy, it has the right to follow you back. And the Lord said, if African leadership finally allow the Holy Spirit to take over, they will not need to struggle. All what has ever been stolen, all the oil is on Ara that has gone to build some other people, those money will come back. Whether they like it or not, it's a divine principle. Jesus said the scriptures cannot be broken. All we need is to get the Holy Spirit seat on the throne. Hallelujah. So that's why you see this kind of vision is something which, even if you are putting all what you have for it, it will not just be for your blessing, it's a blessing for your whole generation. You see, I read to you people on that first day a statement made in the US Senate, which is still very effective. You people understood the statement. Hello? And we can never come out from that kind of network of manipulation except by the hand of Jehovah through the Holy Spirit. So we thank God for our politicians, but politics cannot solve the problem because they were not caused by politics. They were caused spiritually. So it needs spiritual diplomat in the sight of God by the Holy Ghost to sit on. So we are talking about Holy Ghost or Holy Spirit in government. That's why we sang the national anthem. That's why God loves Cameroon, because tomorrow you are going to celebrate 20th May. Let me give you people the spiritual climate of the government of Cameroon. Are you ready to hear it?
Yes.
The nation Cameroon began as a complete nation until when 20th May was established. And those of you who know, that should be 1972, if I'm not mistaken by history. I'm not a historian, but I'm a spiritual historian. Because before then, there were like two nations living in one nation. And do you know that the devil is still trying to keep us in that same spirit? That's why we keep on hearing of Anglophone, Francophone crisis. I asked people the other day, who of you is a British or a Frenchman? Who of you? When God divided the tongues in the Tower of Babel, he gave tongues and culture to every people. We have us to use. We could only invite some if we want, but if it is imposed into you, it is demonic. And it's the source of most of our fighting, you know. If you take off that, it would have solved us so much problems and would have had so much advancement in development. But that spirit of linguistic confusion is arrested now by the power of the Holy Spirit. In the name of Jesus. You never hear bazaar, bayangi problem. You only hear Francophone, Anglophone problem. And even as we sang the national anthem, for those of you who know the lyrics, If you read the lyrics of the national anthem in French and that of English, there is a big difference. In one country, the spirit of division. And you know what the devil does? Because every time the devil sees a good thing coming, what he does is that he's not going to, if he cannot stop it, so he will go and introduce. We could have solved that problem since. We still have, so the Lord told me one of the principles who arrest that spirit of linguistic confusion is that to encourage all Anglophones to learn French. And we are building a library in Christ Resolution Center, which will be as one of the resource centers to empower us to know French. Because it is easy for, if all the Anglophone knows French, we can balance the language faster because the majority are French. But if you want to get the Francophones to must know English, it will take a very long time for this process to be complete. Even though both are advised to do the same. Amen? Amen. So you have you heard one point of Cameroon governmental spiritual climate? Most times you are approaching an office for something, they will not care to look at the quality in you. They will care to find out whether are you an Anglophone or a Francophone, the spirit of division. It's just manipulating the human leaders in position. Until the Holy Spirit takes over, all the effort will be equal to frustration. But God has remembered us in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Now, the second point on Cameroon government spiritual political spiritual history or spiritual climate is this. Until when they were united, and that's when you finally discovered that we had one star in this flag. It was not by accident. Please listen. Everything you find, even in the national anthem, the land of glory is found only in Cameroon national anthem. It is not by accident. The one star is a symbol of unity for God. Whatever they gave the name, I have spiritual names given of what was really supposed to be. The name Cameroon was birthed out of what? What was coming from a river? The spirit of Marine. Hello? But we don't care. Let the name still remain political, but we will still follow spiritual consciousness so that we will not begin to fight when we are supposed to be united. So this is when the nation platform was established. And now this celebration will be what? 37 years. According to biblical mandate of deliverance, it is after the year 40. So I told you people, watch out what will happen in 2012. Because the handwriting is already written. You'll find one of the best nations in the world.
Amen.
There will never be quarreling and fighting unnecessarily when this spirit goes. And according to religious statistics in Cameroon, Christians make the majority. So if this message has already entered, when it goes through the church, it will begin to manifest in the community. 3/4 of the people who are in the offices, taking the bribe and doing the wrong things, are still among Christians. That's why in the course of this revolution, many are going to be crossed over, not just Christians, but from Christians to disciples.
Amen.
Hello? Jesus existed, the word Christian was never mentioned. He died, it was not. Many years after, some people who were unbelievers gave the name, which was good to look like Christ. But how do you take a name defined by an external person, happen to even be an unbeliever? What was the real name God was calling us? So if we lay hold to be so conscious, I'm a Christian, you can never solve a problem just as a Christian because it's the same like a Muslim. Station as a disciple of Jesus Christ. That's why when he died, 12 years, when he died, the 12 he left, they were able to create an impact of that message all over the world. And so, get up from just being a Christian. That's a good name for your religious gathering. But you must be a disciple for community revolution and development. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Disciples.
Some folks will be very early, their knees on the ground, because they are copying the principles of their father. Christians will be sleeping. Disciples will be very early in the morning, not struggling to think about looking for breakfast. They will be thinking about looking for the manna from heaven, the world. Christians will be struggling for breakfast. Are you a Christian or a disciple? If we want this vision, this nation, this continent to change, we must not just be Christians, but we must graduate to become disciples, not by words, but by action, with evidence of fully empowered with knowledge, wisdom from above, and practical application. Hello? Where is the problem? Is it the politician or the church? Do you know that one of the major responsibilities of any church is to make sure they pray and intercede seriously for the government? Those of you who are Bible scholars, you know that it's much many there. And the Lord asked me a question. He said, which of your church back home spend at least 5 hours a week praying for the government? And we blame them for the mistake they make when we have already failed in our own part. And Jesus said, don't try to remove a peck in your brother's eye when there is a lock in yours that you have not removed. That is why the politics in the church is worse than the one in the government. Hello? When Jesus came on earth, he had no problem with publicans. He had no problem with prostitutes. He had no problem with government authority. He had problem with religious leaders. So it doesn't sound strange to me if people go and say funny things. That's their business. It must not be according to your tradition. Just receive the message. Repent. The word repent is not an automatic thing on the day you become born again. They say, have you repented? Repent is an every instant issue when you get a new message. Repent means change your mind. So we need to constantly change our mind as we hear the... Because God's word is not... Let me show you something. Imagine God, his mind, created the whole earth. God, by his mind, created the whole universe. If you count only the size of the earth, or look at the size of the earth, then count the number of planets, then talk about other aspects, the heavens. Only the one kingdom of darkness, one, the earthly kingdom of Satan, is bigger than the whole earth for about 5 times. One. All these things came out from God's mind. You reduce God's mind to be only these. This is just a foundation to be able to give us something to be inspired with. But we need the day-to-day manna from heaven by the Holy Spirit to give us direction every moment. Hallelujah. Amen. That is why Jesus said, give us this day our daily bread. He didn't say give us these days. What is bread? Bread is give us today's. Bread is provision, provision, provision. That's the spiritual meaning of it, which must start with the spiritual provision, which is the word of God for that day. That is what will guide you to apply and get the physical provision without fighting or quarreling, envying, gossiping, or struggling. The church must wake up. Amen?
Amen.
If our environment must be delivered, the church must wake up. Amen?
Amen.
So we will not be fighting. If it's not working, okay, let me show you another thing. Jesus said, whatsoever you bind on earth shall be what? Whatsoever you loose on earth shall be what? To whom was Jesus making that statement? Was it to Christians? That means disciples have the ability to stay here and decide what will be the decisions taken from the parliament. And so I want to announce to you as I round up in this first phase, tomorrow you will get the complete picture. Because the word of God has announced evil leadership is dead.
Amen.
Tomorrow we will put it in the coffin and we will bury him by fire.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's the only solution to our crisis. That's the only solution to our crisis. And the Lord told me, he said, you are going to, by activation, connect with other great men and women, young prophets raised in the land, build, set up what they call an intercessory group for the parliament. This group will be meeting the same time the parliament is meeting. As they are interceding with their knees, whatever the devil is trying to conspire to misinterpret in the parliament must change, because fire will visit them. Yeah. Will you regret supporting this kind of vision? No. Amen. We are going to meet for a spiritual parliament. Physical manifestation is a play, a drama that is written in the spirit. So we have failed to do the spiritual responsibility. It has caused the physical decisions taken by the politician to be wrong and affect us. Now we are sitting up to begin to do the spiritual responsibility. Hello? Why should I pray evil prayer for President Paul Biya? For what? I should pray God to bless him. Because if he takes a wrong decision, it's affecting me too. So I should pray for God to bless him. And then let God himself put his rod of judgment. Because if I pray God to bless him, he will have the opportunity to be inspired so that he can decide rightly. But if he refuses, then God can judge him because somebody was praying for God to bless him. Hello? The reason why, even if he makes a mistake, God will still allow him, because nobody is praying for God to bless him. Have you tried in your church? You don't intercede for your pastor. Do you see the mistake he's making? Thank you, Jesus. So we are not interceding for the national pastor. That's why there are mistakes. Why Muslims are interceding for him. So their decisions are inspired by the spirit of Islam. And what is the spirit of Islam? Is it good or bad? Hello? That's one, another indication of the government's spiritual climate. Because go and check your books or your... Do you even know the order of the cabinet of your country? 3/4 of the people who doesn't know things about their nation are Christians. Ask how many people, how many articles do you even have in your constitution? You don't know. That's why you don't even also know the Bible. You ignore the environment you are living in. And you expect some people to make it be the best. That's why you find 3/4 of the people trying to escape to go to Europe and America, majority are Christian. And one day the Holy Spirit spoke something to me. I was troubled in my spirit. He said, Christians are running out, occultists are running in. And who are those who will be leading? Shame. 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 You must be delivered in the name of Jesus. God is crying, shedding tears. Because God can never take a mediocre to put him where does not fit him. He says, study and show yourself approved. So don't look at two people. This is a Christian. This is a Muslim. The Muslim happened to qualify somehow, even though not, and has a little bit of spiritual strength, even though negative. And a Christian is there. This Christian, the Jesus spiritual strength, he doesn't have. He does not even know how many books are in the Old Testament. Then talk less of New Testament. And then he doesn't even have the training in that office. Who do you think God will give that office to? Tell yourself, I must wake up. God is waiting for me. Hello? Tomorrow is 20th May. That's why we will not have any morning session here, because we must be involved in the activities of the government. And the government shall be upon the soldier. Let me give you the last mystery in that. Who is the head of the church? So suppose that I'm standing here as Christ. This is the head, Christ. And the government happens to be here. And what is the church? The church is the body of Christ. And so, do you see the government being part of that body? So that separation has killed us. One of the things I studied in America about their political, spiritual climate was that in the very beginning, the nations were established by men of God. Here you want to hear some denomination or their religious perspective. Let me tell you something what God told me. There are many pastors who are struggling to run churches, whereas God has already called them to be involved in government.
Amen.
And they are there fighting members. You have taken my sheep as if they have become Jesus. You must think if you find yourself in the wrong place, because there's no grace there anymore. You can be a pastor today. God calls you now to be involved in a certain part of administration. Maybe you are supposed to be the government delegate of the city, or maybe the mayor. You'll be there struggling. No. Politics. Those are the things that has killed us. For example, let me show something. In the church, if they don't preach serious message about healing, will somebody ever receive healing? So since the church has not been preaching a message concerning leadership and government, people have those calls in them in the church, but they cannot be inspired. And they are struggling to do something else, whereas God is waiting them for something else. Nobody was created for two different reasons. God has a unique reason. The thing is that by God's permissible will for people, people are doing many wrong things which God did not create them for. And it looks like it's walking in a pain and they say, oh, God is with me. When God is with you, you don't struggle. There's too much grace. Amen? Do you see me struggling to preach this message? It's just coming. That's one of the problems I had for the first time I preached a first message somewhere. So many pastors were challenged. Because people were going and saying that boy is just preaching, he's not even reading anything and stuff. I should have been doing my electrical engineering. I begged God even to surrender, to leave me alone. Because those who have happened to be my student in electronic class, they know exactly what God was doing. But God said, what is your name? Hello? So these are the things that must put the Holy Spirit in government. Now let me show you, how would the Holy Spirit sit in government? For the Holy Spirit to come on you, what did you do? You needed first of all to receive Jesus Christ as a Lord and personal Savior. If you did not do that, was he going to be? Okay. So how do you expect the Holy Spirit to be in the government? He cannot go there on his own. We must bring him there. Hello? And to bring him there is to apply the principles of God in the Bible and begin to allow the message be the message that is coming. Because in every generation, God is not a respecter of people, neither their age, their tribes. But he says, anyone that fears him and does his will, he will reveal himself to him. And so he has people, he will be giving them words to direct that generation in that era. And in this perspective, God began the deliverance of Africa from manipulation of independence. He raised a man called Kwame Nkrumah, who was a man of God. But history book told us that he was a politician. And the man began to pioneer that dream because God showed him that this is my desire. The spirit of dependence is a spirit. Dependence, in short, what they call dependence is the spirit of slavery that manifested in another form. And today that spirit of dependence is still working in another form. And that is why God was crucified by the Holy Spirit in government in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
It's still working in another form. When we have a small problem here, we cannot sit and look how to solve it and look at God. We are looking external, America, Europe. Because even in the church we are doing that. That's why the government also is doing that. When we don't correct it spiritually, it will not be corrected physically. Hello? Because whether you like it or not, any message preached in the church has a spiritual effect to the activities of the government. It's on the shoulder. So that's the spiritual atmosphere we find ourselves in. So there are many people you find in a leadership position, you know for sure that there are many who are involved in different things. Don't struggle to them. God is the one responsible to keep people there. If he finds the man that he will replace, he will remove them without any gunshot. No quarrel, no violence. But for God to remove a window and put a door, he better allow the window. Hello? So you better prepare yourself. So that those who are there will change for your good. If they don't change, they will be chased. By the hand of Jehovah. In the name of Jesus. That's all we need. So the man Nkrumah pioneered that era of African civilization for us to come out for what we now celebrate as independence. And Nkrumah constantly made the statement because it was a vision for Africa. And hear what God told me, the reason why the man of God did not come from Nigeria. He said, when he gave Nkrumah that dream, it was Nkrumah to pioneer it and to make sure it manifests and prove himself in Ghana. So those of you must have read history, you see that era of African independence began there. So now it was easy for the other leaders in other parts of Africa to understand that this is a message because they saw the evidence. So God wants you Cameroonians to prove the evidence so that Africa together will come out from this evil system of leadership to the system of leadership of the Holy Spirit in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Stand on your feet. Only Jesus can save. And I want you to be meditating on what you have heard. You owe God a responsibility to be part of this to happen. That's why no matter what the devil did to stop you, he could not. God allow you to be here. And God cannot use you because something happened without blessing you. Thank you, Jesus. So tomorrow, we'll be ending it. The message is that when you are coming tomorrow, don't dress in any European dress. This suit will no more be on me tomorrow. You are supposed to be proud to be a Cameroonian with whatever culture you identify yourself. If I had a sanja, I would tie it. Somebody can borrow me one. Hello? Somebody spoke about blessing the man of God, so you can bless me with that one. Only Jesus can save. I want you to sing a song and do whatever God tells you to do. Because that's the answer.
And people of this are great continent, Africa.
We have allowed our cultics to struggle to have, but they could not. They have failed. Now Jesus has begun a new era.
Cannot say and change our great country. It takes only Jesus, who died on the cross of Calvary, to bring salvation, deliverance in this hour. Yes.
Hallelujah. Somebody shout hallelujah. Are you proud to be a Cameroonian?
Yes.
Are you proud to be an African?
Yes.
Are you proud to be a black man?
Yes.
Put your hands together for Jesus. I want you to repeat this after me as you close your eyes. Say,
with Christ,
with Christ,
there is no failure.
There is no
failure.
Say it again.
Of Christ,
in Christ,
in Christ,
with Christ,
there is no failure.
There is no failure.
Of Christ,
in Christ,
in Christ,
with Christ,
there is no failure.
The Holy Spirit
is now in the government
of our land.
We are now saved.
Jesus alone
is our Savior.
Put your hands together for Jesus. Take your seat for a minute. I'm going to pray a prayer. I told you about the 9 pillars, spiritual pillars that holds Kumba, and which were all evil, but God is changing the case by rebuilding the pillars. You know about the mystery of the world. God upholds the earth by what? Pillars. Those of you who read the Bible. According to spiritual platter, every city or every environment is kept by spiritual pillars. So Kumba happened to have 9. And I started showing you where they are. So when you are moving every day, when you get to some of those people, begin to speak the word of God. Let them be dethroned. They are not existing physically, but they are existing spiritually. They are resisting the move of the gospel. But God, by the Spirit, has visited us. Amen?
Amen.
In every city, also spiritually, there are gates. That's why Jesus said, I shall build my church and the gates of hell shall not prevail. When he was making that statement, because he knows that there will always be gates to prevail. In the city of Kumba, there are 3 major gates, and all the 3 motor parks, they are found there. And one of them is the headquarter, which is based by the railway. So when you are moving by those places, begin to speak the word of God. Let the blood of Jesus soak the land. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
In the nation of Cameroon, there is an altar that keeps a nation. That's why when God sent the young prophet to go to Jeroboam, he was prophesying about altar. Every nation is kept by an altar. And in Cameroon, we have one, which happens to be evil, between the National Assembly and the Quartier General, or the military headquarters. Because every strength of any nation physically is based on the laws coming from the assembly and the strength of the military. But this time, by God's sake, we will not be spending money to buy war arms. We will have military that will be there to help us for internal peace. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because when those altars now become the altars of the Holy Ghost, they will be speaking by the Prince of Peace message.
Yes.
And the decisions coming from the assembly will be the decisions of the Bible. Hello?
Hi.
And so 2 major symbols erected in Cameroon, as the man of God said here when he was speaking, some of you thought that he was just speaking because he's a financial minister. But a mountain, if you know about the significance of mountain in the Bible, it's a worship contact point for Cameroon. That's why when the early people who were exploring the land, they saw it, they described it to be chariots of fire. That's where our name was originally to be baptized. But we are coming back to it in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You know what the chariots of fire mean? The chariots of God. So a time is coming where people will not be running mountain race to take Guinness. They will be running mountain race for worship to Jehovah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
God did not put those things there by accident. They were put all to worship him. What did he say? Let every living thing do what? Do you know that according to the law of the Spirit, there's nothing dead? Because everything was created by a living God. So all those things, the twin lock you have in Kupem Manunguba, they were not kept there to worship the devil, which people go there and do all kind of sacrifice. And things are happening in Yaoundé. This time, they will be for good in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And so there are 3
rivers that hold the spiritual platform of this nation. One of them is River Meme, one is River Manu. You may be surprised to hear it. And another one is the river that is called Menchum Falls, running into River Saga. They will not be flowing now by evil sacrifices. Men will not go there to do ritualistic sacrifices. They will go there to baptize people in the name of Jesus. Amen. The Holy Spirit is working. And so the Lord said, as I told you people, Kumba was chosen as Bethel for the altar to be established. Yes. And do you know that there's a spiritual relationship between Kumba and Manfi? Are you ready to hear it now?
Yes.
You hear it tomorrow. Hallelujah. Let me just show you a glimpse. Look at how God is raising many mighty men of God within this environment. It's not by accident. Because God can never do a thing on his own. He has to use people that he will raise them to connect, to walk in corporate connection to a particular vision for a fulfillment. Like they say, when the big vision manifests, every small vision will be blessed. Because this is the era of the manifestation of the black race, the last seal of the end time message. Christ now manifesting, not just as a spiritual leader, but a ruler to rule, even by the Holy Spirit through his people. Amen?
Amen.
So the Lord told me again and said, just like you see in the Bible, have you heard of the word Bethlehem? Have you heard of the word Bethel? Have you heard of the word Jerusalem?
Yes.
Count Kumba, Manfi, and Yaoundé. Put your hands together for Jesus.
Lieta sata katasano ya fidlebro kadagaride goriadala dagazite riapraparode rikasata barode sharia. The revival that will hit these places, you will be surprised. Le katarabro kadedianda la bababa. Lift up your hands and begin to bless his name and begin to receive your own part of this vision. Let the spiritual atmosphere feel that you are part of what God is doing. Only Jesus can save. The Holy Spirit now in government. Our nation shall be well the way they are supposed to be, because Christ is already ruling the world. Because Christ is already ruling the world. Because Christ is already ruling the world. The Holy Spirit in government. Thank you, Father. Talk to me. Talk to him. Talk with him. He's your father. He loves you. Father, everyone that is present here within and without, their destinies are connected to this same fulfillment in this nation and in this continent and the world. Everyone that the devil has deviated their focus in life and they are concerned in things which are not part of their destiny, I command a revisiting tonight in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I command a visitation tonight in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The value system of your people shall be directed according to the Spirit of God tonight in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
No one shall be disappointed for any reason from tonight in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Everyone shall be proud to be a Cameroonian from tonight in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Everyone shall be concerned and be focused to do the assignment you have given him in this nation in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Lord, people receive their healing in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
In their spirit, they receive it in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
In their soul, they receive it in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
In their body, they receive it in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Now, do you know if the Bible announced Christ coming as a governor and he is not here physically, he is here spiritually, it is his spirit that will be the governor. But it will be through the ones that have received him. The reason why the human system of government can never survive to solve any problem until the Holy Spirit takes over is because it is written in Psalms 127 verse 1, except the Lord builds a house, the labor in vain that builds it. Except the Lord watch over a city, the watchmen do what? Watch in vain. So all the security system that we have put in place, it cannot stop corruption. It needs angels. So the nations was built But until the Lord is building it now, the building is in vain. And that is what God is purposed to do. And I want you to receive whatever God tells you and run with it, because it will be a blessing, not just for you, but for your generation and the entire land. The Bible says, even creation await the manifestation of what? The sons of God. So the land, they need deliverance. The trees, the Boya Mountains, the rivers you have heard, they need deliverance. The lakes, and because they are not delivered, they are using them against you. So we must stand with God for the Holy Spirit to take over for them to be delivered. Hallelujah. As you close your eyes, receive that baptism to be connected to this new revolution in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Receive that baptism for this new era of the message of Jesus Christ in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Receive that baptism that you are blessed for this to come out of Cameroon in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Father. Any one of you God lays in your heart to do anything to support this vision, to support whatever concerning the man of God, the vision, whatever, do it. It's not for the man's gain, it's for your own blessing. God will never bypass you to bless someone. He must bless you to be a blessing to others. So by the time the God will be putting the structure the way they are supposed to be, by your commitment to follow the dream, he will pick bet you and begin to position you there. And you will be proud that you are not just a child of God by gathering and making empty noise, but you have a role in your community. Some of you, God will speak to you. You have a lot of responsibility in this government, in this nation, administration, in many forms. Don't kill it for religious purpose. Whatever the Holy Spirit tells you, as far as it's not for a selfish gain, is the will of God. Hello? Thank you, Heavenly Father. Let it be done unto your people. Tomorrow you are coming, come with your proud, fully cultural dress. I did not hear a big amen.
Amen.
Now, if you have any material flag, be it paper, frame them and bring. When we finish celebrating the 20th May, politically, we will celebrate it spiritually, because the foundation is established. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Put your hands together for Jesus as the man of God says.
How many people have been blessed tonight? Hallelujah. So we're going to go home preparing to come tomorrow to celebrate. Tomorrow is going to be a celebration day. Amen. Hallelujah. Come ready to dance, come ready to jump, come ready to, in fact, celebrate. Why others will be dancing in the nightclub? Others will be drinking beer. We'll be dancing for Jesus, and we'll be drinking the Holy Ghost in Jesus' name.
Yes,
hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen and amen.
Amen.
I want to thank everybody who came today, especially for the ministers, man of God who came all the way, Dwala. You are welcome, sir. Amen. Hallelujah. I want to say that tomorrow is the last day, so if you are coming tomorrow, come with somebody. Amen. What God did not do in day one, day two, day three, day four, I believe He'll do it tomorrow. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
This conference has been a conference of information. Amen.
Amen.
For you to gather more information, knowledge. The Bible says, we perish not because we don't pray, not because we don't fast. But the people perish because of lack of knowledge. If you are not very, very conversant with God's principle, financial principle, if you can't fast 100 days, poverty will still slap you in the face. Are you hearing me, somebody? We are living at a time when we need to know. The Bible says, they that know their God shall wax strong and do great exploit. Amen. All these things that they have been telling us, if you are going to be part of that generation that is going to do exploit, you need to run after knowledge. You need to study to show yourself approved, not of your neighbor or your friend. Some people, when they compare their spirituality with their neighbors, they say, oh, I pass you. They stop learning. But the day you stop learning, that day you start dying. Because the Bible says, he that thinketh that he knoweth does not know as he ought to know. So there is a level that you ought to know. This kind of meetings, you never have a full house. They said that if you want to hide any information from a black man, put it in a book. Even right now, if you pass this information through the radio or the television, some people will not hear it. But I believe you have the kind of program that I say, there's somebody here! They're going to have dreams. This place will be full. But you need to go to places where you have the twins and be able to know how to bring up the twins. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now the reason why we cannot compete in any area. Talk about politics. So no, politics is not for Christians. We'll allow the unbelievers to rule us and begin to complain. Who told you that politics is not for Christians? Joseph was the prime minister. Are you hearing? Look, listen to me tonight. People like Daniel, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. In a foreign land, they were leading, they were rulers. But today, you want to talk about politics. You don't find any born again. But you find a born against. Feel the whole place. You understand what I'm saying? So you are receiving information to help us to be able to lead. God is looking for Christians to put in positions. But if you cannot find any, what do you want to do? Say somebody, hey, you can be the governor of me? No. No. Can never be. Even if they're prophesying, we'll refuse. Some people say Obama is a Christian, it's not a lie. Christ must be president. See our trouble. Knowledge. Yeah, never go after knowledge. Amen.
Amen.
If you just know that Christ died for your sins and for your sicknesses, you'll be healed. Knowledge. But you always want to be like, loose. You go back home, say, don't come back. Lie, pastor. You need knowledge. God will help this generation in Jesus' name.
Amen.
It seems as if as the conference is coming to a close, the population is decreasing. You know why? Because as you go up the mountain, mountains go like this. Mountain goes like this. Do you understand? Some of you are even making up your mind that tomorrow you'll not come. I want to go and celebrate 20 minutes somewhere. I remove that spirit from you tonight. You will come in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen and amen.
Amen.
Let's rise on our feet and surround us tonight. Amen. God is good. I tell you tomorrow when coming, they say bring an African. Africa. Some people don't know African way. If you don't know African way, just bring European way. We'll still flow. Amen. Because somebody can go and put coat and ties on there. Now think that they can't dress in that.
Tonight, folks, land.
In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray tonight. Amen.
Amen.
May we share the grace. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit rest and abide with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our life, forever and ever. Amen. Can you put your hands together for the Lord who created Cameroon? Hallelujah. God bless you. See you tomorrow evening. And I wonder the time. God bless you.
no more knowledge within the land. No transfer of knowledge anymore. And that's when that continent began. But God is turning the case in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
So the Bible told us in the book of Acts that there was a time God allowed people to be looking for him because the way they did things, that's where most of our ancestors went and they were worshiping many things that is affecting us now. But thank God, God is redeeming us as we are crying to him for forgiveness in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And so after that time, they should have connected back to their God, but that confusion that took place kept them astray. What do you still want to hear? God is a fool to create you who you are. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Now, the word civilization, as you hear, started with Africa. So, civilization is a pioneer instrument for world development. So, development actually started with Africa. And you can be surprised to hear, the very first cloth, cotton cloth, what they call it, kind of cotton, was found in Nigeria many years back, before you started hearing all this what we are buying now. Hello?
Hi.
You can be surprised to hear the name Havila is part of Africa. And that's the land which the Bible says the water flow from the first flow. And that land was carrying gold, delium, and all what you hear. So you find all those things in Africa everywhere. But this is the point. Africans all over are supposed to live as one because that's how God created them. That's why the devil has to do everything to continue to divide us, because in that division he has access to manipulate us. But he has failed in the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
We will no more be fighting. And God raised a man of God called Kwame Nkrumah that you must have read in history. Many of you will not know that he was a man of God. God would never do a thing for a change of a land except he raised a man. Nkrumah had a vision for Africa to come out from the manipulation of the spirit of dependence. And he did to his degree. But the greatest shock, he was ousted out in a coup and he died on exile out of Ghana. Can you imagine the wickedness of devil? And Nkrumah made a statement time and again. He said the independence of Ghana is of no meaning except the whole of Africa has their independence, a vision. And the Lord spoke to me now. He said the first phase of African independence was established, which was a political independence. But we are still in mental dependency. That is why our leaders cannot do anything within what they have. They will always want to wait for IMF. They want to wait for foreign assistance, which means they give to them in one way and cause their people to suffer in another way. Because human leaders will be sponsored with a small, meager bribery and continue to keep the population in slavery. And they have to impose to us to privatize things we were not supposed to. The wickedness of men. And you tell me that we don't need the Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. And the Lord said we must come out from what I call mental slavery. There's still slavery in another form. The same spirit that started in slavery, when he was caught that way, he manifested in dependence. He transformed now after independence, now to spiritual dependence. That's why your mind must receive a complete transformation in the name of Jesus. If that fire must burn, the light of the gospel must stay in your mind 24/7 in the name of Jesus. Go ahead and begin to bless God for what you have heard and thank him for being a proud person to be a black man. For God is not a fool to create you to for who you are. Lord, we bless you. We thank you. We give you praise. We adore you. We thank you, Lord. Whatever mistake was made in our land, oh God, we ask you that the land is going to be delivered. Our leadership, Lord, shall be perfect according to your hand, according to your righteousness. Are you ready to see this land delivered?
Yes.
I told you I've not been able to still get the map of Kumba up to now, but I saw 9 pillars erected by that confusion when our ancestors were worshipping idol, and around them are all blood, which means evil pillars. So it's resisting the light of development. Let me tell you what Jesus is in terms of practical terms. Do you want to hear?
Yes.
Jesus came on earth for two missions. Number one, spiritual, number two, physical. But he is God, so he's a spirit being. He has no right to stay on earth permanently. So he manifested the spiritual mission and then went back to come to us through the Holy Spirit so that we can manifest the physical vision. Hallelujah. And so the first part, when Jesus came, he picked the book and read it. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me to do what? Do all that, he ended, and to preach the acceptable year of the Lord. What was Jesus doing? He was quoting from Isaiah 61. And he ended where it has to continue with the physical mission. So the physical mission started with the day of vengeance. Tell somebody, the day of vengeance is around. The day of vengeance is around. That means we are praying for God to help our people, those who have been associating with the devil because of ignorance, to change. But if they refuse to change, this world will chase them out.
Yes.
Because the bridges must be built. The broken walls must be restored.
Yes.
The broken roads must be restored.
Yes.
So that's all what Jesus' mission was. And that is why he announced himself, what? I am the way, the truth, and the life. What does this mean? The way means, according to God's agenda, when a community is following God's perspective, all roads will be perfectly established. The way is roads. One of the greatest difficulties to our development is bad roads. If the light of the gospel is shedding in the hearts of the leaders, there will be provision for every good road everywhere. And we need to do that because we don't need to blame them. But we need to play our part as a church for a supernatural touch. I asked somebody somewhere, I said, how many churches in Africa spend at least 5 hours every week praying for their president? You will never find any church. And they keep on blaming them for the mistake they made. How can you expect darkness to produce anything good? Hallelujah!
Yeah.
And so Jesus said, I am the way, because there is no way you can have a new good development in a place if there are no roads. And then he said, I am the way, the truth. What is the truth? The truth is light. That's why we have problem of electricity, because the truth has not come to development. But very soon there will no more be power failure in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
So you go to a big nation like Nigeria, you see doubt why they are suffering in electricity like we are suffering. Because Jesus has not been practically preached. But the first phase was preached. We thank God for the great men of God. And we bless God for what they have done. But this is our era for the practical phase to be preached. Because the final phase must be the spiritual plus the practical to make it complete. That is why in this phase you don't pursue the things in emotionalism. Without the spiritual strength, you will be destroyed. The devil is not joking. And the life. What is life? Life was originally manifested physically in the beginning. When God created the heavens and the earth was without form and void. And the Spirit of the Lord moved upon what? Water. That's why when Jesus is practically preached, you will not have complaints of people struggling to get pure water. Three major aspects of Jesus' ministry in the Spirit manifesting practically would have given the best community everywhere. And this is that day, because it's African Day. In the name of Jesus.
Yes.
Now close your eyes with me and say, Lord, deliver our land.
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 For the mistakes of our ancestors.
For the mistakes of our ancestors.
We repent.
We repent.
On behalf of our ancestors. We repent
on
our own mistakes.
By the blood of Jesus,
we call for redemption
on the land of Kumba.
By the blood of Jesus,
we call for redemption
on the land of Cameroon.
By the blood of Jesus,
our land. Let every element of creation
in our land be delivered
by our manifestation.
In the name of Jesus,
we speak for total redemption
of our lives.
of our land. Let the black race begin to manifest according to God's agenda. We thank you, Lord, for what you are doing, for raising men and women to stand on behalf of the land, for the deliverance of the land. In the name of Jesus, we ask for the collapse of all evil altars standing on our land. We stand as a people of one nation under Christ Jesus for the redemption of our land, of Cameroon, of Africa. We stand as one people under Christ, because we know we are of Christ, we are in Christ, and we are walking with Christ. Therefore we shall not fail. Therefore we shall not fail. In the name of Jesus, we shall not fail. In the name of Jesus, the plan of God for this continent must be fulfilled. Oh Lord, let justice prevail in the nation of Cameroon. Let justice prevail in the nation of Africa. We use this flag as a point of contact against every work of wickedness in this land. We use this flag as a point of contact against every work of evil in our leadership. We pray for their redemption. Let the word of God redeem them and bless them. Bless our leaders that they will find fulfillment, that the Holy Spirit is to help them lead their people for the fulfillment of destiny. In the name of Jesus. Now go ahead and begin to speak to God and stretch your hand towards this flag as a point of contact. Begin to speak to God and stretch your hand towards this flag. And this we are connecting to all Africa. So everyone who is present here, to any from any African country, we are one. God has begun a new era. Lord, let your will be done in Cameroon. Let your will be done in Kumba. Let your will be done in Cameroon. We command the collapse of all the evil altars that are speaking against this land. We command their collapse in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Lord, we stand as your people. You are for a new breed of civilization. We thank you, Lord, for the institution. We thank you for our brothers and sisters. Let the katakara prakari adolepo. Let the gerepo kori adolepo adolepo. Hey, ah. Precious name we have prayed. Now I want everyone to focus on this flag. As I have explained to you by those revelations, Cameroon is a center for this revival for Africa to bless the world. So everything we are doing, we are connecting the whole of Africa. Let me show you a lot of mysteries about Cameroon. This star was not put by accident. But much of what is written about the star is not what we are experiencing because of the devil. But as the Holy Spirit is taking over, because Christ is already ruling, amen, we'll begin to see unity. Amen. I don't care whatever the politician made as mistakes. It was not by accident that Funcha and the rest decided that we should be united. That's why you hear so much on 20th May. So the unity of Cameroon will speak for the unity of Africa.
Amen.
And will bring back the one nation God created.
Amen.
As the sons of God. And that way God will use us to lead the world. That's the handwriting of Obama.
Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. So the word of God has for you as an advice. Never be part of any riot, even when our politicians make mistakes. They have to make those mistakes because the Holy Spirit is not leading through them. We only have to pray for them. The Bible says the government is part of the body of Christ. So when Jesus was coming, the prophecy was announced for a governor. He was not a religious church leader. He is the head of the church, and the government happened to be part of the soldier. So what does that mean? The Holy Spirit is taking over.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So now you are going to stretch your hands to this flag. Because God has already announced the day of vengeance. Any wickedness of man through manipulation, whether they connect them through United Nations or whatsoever, and they still stand to stand against this, and they are influencing corruption and evil in this nation, Jehovah himself will begin to descend. They only have to repent. All Jesus said, if he goes on them, he will grind them. But if they come to him, he will break them. It means he will make them humble and they will repent. Most of our leaders, if they tell you places they are entering, you will not believe. People, they are bowing to them, but when they stand before you in public, they are giving you commands. Wicked craftiness of the devil, enslaving us, people well educated, you find them sleeping down, naked, in people who do not even brush their teeth, in the name of their protecting talismans. Let them come to the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
He will protect them. And that's what we are praying, so that they will not die. Because if they are coming to the Holy Spirit, we will have the best leadership in the world.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
It began with us in the Bible. Nimrod formed the first government. So we do not need to borrow any democracy somewhere. And very soon you will hear it on the 20th May, Christ democracy taking over.
Amen.
The United Nations democracy. Amen. Hallelujah. Stretch your hands to this flag and begin to speak whatever the Holy Spirit put in your heart concerning Africa. Just begin to speak as the Lord leads you. Go ahead as you stretch your hand towards that flag. Lete kata parakataria kaloro bruka daragade. Regede godo gobro gadagaria delere godo robro. Regede gozeke tekeria dalara ba 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 ba. Regede gozeke tekeria delere godo robro kada ba 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 ba. Regede gozeke tekeria delere godo robro kada ba 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 ba. Holy Ghost, let your will, O God, for Africa be established. Let the unity of Cameroon be established. Part of this move. Hear what the Holy Spirit told me about Kumba. He said, I choose Kumba to be better.
Yes.
Hallelujah. So that's why by ignorance the devil missed or led our ancestors and they shed blood, and that blood was resisting that divine choice. So as I was praying, I saw 9 pillars standing against that purpose, and they are one of the reasons for all the divisions and confusion. But God has remembered the land.
Yeah.
I have been able to pick 7 of the pillars where they are, but I needed the map to get the remaining 2. And so, hallelujah. Say glory to Jesus. Say thank you, Holy Spirit. Now, if you look at Town Green, that's one pillar. You look at, I don't know how to call that place, where Bisekis, that's another, where another pillar is. You look at Tavern, that's where another pillar is. And then you begin to move now to Kumba Town. The next pillar is here, and the next pillar is by Cardiff Junction, and the next pillar is by, how do they call that place, Bongero Junction. And then the next pillar, I saw it right at Lake Barombi, and I'm tracing the other 2. I need the map to get where they are. By God's special grace, the prophet of God raised in this land will begin to move and do a prophetic march and anoint, destroy those pillars. And they will be transformed to the altar of righteousness.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's why you see a move of revival is blowing in Kumba, because the altar must be built.
Amen.
And when he finishes, he will begin to move. And the next stop will be Manfi. These are areas where the devil has worked to hinder the development of this nation, which is stopping Africa to get to what God wants to do. In Manfi, many people in the name of politics went to all kinds of covenants and sold the land. And that is why you have all the great academicians from Manfi, but you see no sign of development there. Because they didn't know that what they were doing in the past is going to speak against the future of the land. And you find in Manfi a river that is a star known as Sansangio. But last time when I was there, we raised an altar there, and that altar is speaking. God will crumble everything that is there at his appointed time in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And after that, we'll move to Yaoundé and destroy the last altar that is speaking against the politics.
Yes.
From there, you shall find parliamentarians that will go for parliament.
Listen, this year 2009, God reveals 9 pillars resisting the plan of God for Kumba and Cameroon and Africa. I asked God, why did you not reveal it last year? He said, because it was not a number. This year 2009, Cameroon began as a nation when they united completely. So this 20th May will be the 37th. It's remaining 3 to meet the number of deliverance. Watch out what will happen in 2012. And I want to announce to you, this conference this year will end, the one next year will start. In 2010, the conference will start, but on December, and it will cross to 2011 on the New Year Day. And you know what is supposed to be in Cameroon in 2011. So you don't need to be worried. God is in charge. Tell your neighbor the Holy Spirit is in charge. Hallelujah. Put your hands together for Jesus. So we are standing. The man of God from Nigeria was supposed to join us by today. But when I spoke with him, he asked me, how many days do you want me to speak? I spoke from the Spirit and I gave him the days. Later on, when I made the program, I forgot. So God changed it. That's why he's not here now. So when I was speaking with him and we were making arrangements, the Holy Spirit reminded me, remember the exact date I told you. And then he went ahead and said something. He said, you both should go ahead with Evangelist Mukwele and start. Because we needed to play this place of Cameroon to bring Nigeria for Africa. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Father, we thank you. You have spoken. You have blessed. Deliverance has begun. And it's going to hit all over Africa. Every form of wickedness trying to resist what you have done. Because you have already announced the day of vengeance. And you say you must recompense. We pray, Lord, that they will repent. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Lord, we thank you. Because you have purposed to speak. And you have begun. You have established the altar in Kumba as better. When you picked Israel, it was a symbol for the world. But it was not for the end time move. You have picked Cameroon as a symbol for Africa for the end time move. We bless you, Lord. Let every power that you have bestowed in Nigeria, let us allow you to put the hand and release the trigger. We command the death of every form of religion in this country. In the name of Jesus. We arrest the death of every form of denominationalism and doctrinalism. In the name of Jesus. Lord, your word declares that the wicked shall not go unpunished. And you said in your word, Jesus, that the scriptures cannot be broken and that you do not come to counsel them. Neither you came to fulfill them. Let that scripture be fulfilled in Cameroon in the name of Jesus. Let that scripture be fulfilled in Cameroon in the name of Jesus. Let that scripture be fulfilled in Cameroon in the name of Jesus. Let that scripture be fulfilled in Cameroon in the name of Jesus. Let that scripture be fulfilled in Cameroon in the name of Jesus. Human agent connecting with any form of the devil, we give them the opportunity to repent. If they don't, the Lord himself will come on them. Let us begin to speak in the Holy Ghost right now. Your will will be done in Kumba. Thank you, Lord, for the angels. Let us see the go paper. Mire che te kere progodereha, res magarito borogode, riga do go 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 they shall drink their own blood. 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 In the name of Jesus. All flesh eaters in Africa that they are causing all kind of wars in the name of riot, in the name of politics, they shall eat their own flesh. 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 In the name of Jesus. The day of vengeance has announced. Witchcraft power that is resisting any person's destiny here. I command those power to die. I command them to die. I command them to die. I command them to die. In the name of Jesus. Woo! Let your people be loose. Rico, sir, let them be loose. Rico, sir, let them be loose. Let them be loose. Let them be loose. Let them be loose.
You evil pillars, the King of Glory has entered Kumba. He has entered, he has entered, he has entered, he has entered. Bethel is established, Bethel is established, Bethel is established. Right at the center of Kumba. Everyone sick, lay your hands where you are sick. Lay Brukatarada. Pastor Humble, bring, open my bag and bring that anointing oil. Everyone sick, lay your hand where you are sick. Everyone sick, the anointing of God that is here to heal the land will heal your body. The anointing of God that is healing the land, we have repented. The Bible says, if my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and repent of their sins, I shall hear their prayer and heal their land and heal them of any form of infirmity. You are now receiving your healing. The Bible says, he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities, and the chastisement of our peace is upon our Lord Jesus. It was upon him. And now by his stripes we are healed. Receive your healing in the name of Jesus. The land of Cameroon is healed. You will receive your healing in the name of Jesus. You will receive your healing together with the land in the name of Jesus. As a point of contact, the land is healed in the name of Jesus. As a point of contact, the land is healed in the name of Jesus. Receive your healing in Jesus' name. 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 Go ahead and begin to speak to God right now. Mele rego da ba 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 ba. Rekete karia dele rebo karia dele rebo karia dele rebo. Rekosete karia da ba 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 ba. You are healed. You are healed. That infirmity is no more there. The strife of Jesus is complete to heal you. And we have been redeemed by the blood of the Lamb. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Lord. We bless you, Father. We give you praise. We give you praise. We give you praise. Father, let your children sleep with the host of heaven tonight. Let them have dreams of angels fellowshipping with them in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let destinies which are changed remain permanently higher in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you for the young ones you've touched, and you will run with them. We bless you, Lord, in Jesus' precious name.
Amen,
amen and amen and amen.
Amen.
Put your hands together for Jesus and take your seat. God bless you. Hallelujah. God yesterday, and you have so much testimony, just begin to testify whatever you do to the glory of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Just stay on it and claim it. Don't change your confession until you begin to feel it physically in the name of Jesus. Tomorrow we'll still continue. By the grace of God, the man of God will arrive. If not in the evening, then he will be here on Tuesday. Tomorrow in the morning we'll still be here. We were here in the morning from 4 a.m. to 5 a.m. I told you that Jesus Christ said, if we must make it, our righteousness must precede the righteousness of the Pharisees. Our present day Pharisees are religious leaders, which include Islamic leaders, occultic leaders, our Christian leaders, who do not want to be disciples, to follow the terms of the Holy Spirit. That's why you find pastors fighting pastors. When they are insufficient, the ability of insecurity, they start competing unnecessarily. Can you imagine what would have been? Who would have been the people who would have been full? Who would have been the people to fill the whole of this place? But it's not a surprise, it's in the Bible. Jesus left the rabbis in the temple and went to the sea, was looking for fishermen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So we'll still be here at 4 a.m. to 5 a.m. Because that's when occultic altars are raising the arrows to the Queen of Heaven against your destiny. And those who were here, they got a mystery about the meaning of a star. So you need to be there. I encourage you to be part of it. I want those who will join me for a fast as this program is unfolding, especially beginning from tomorrow. At least if you can keep a fast from morning to 6, God bless you. If you cannot, at least 2, praying for this land and this continent. And if you can join us in the morning prayers, it will be powerful. But now we're standing at 8 a.m. to 11 a.m. We were supposed to have ministers' conference. The Lord has spoken that we'll change it. We'll have leadership conference. And all of you are leaders in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
come and you will receive the secret of preparing yourself for the elite that God is going to put you. You will be surprised. Many of them will be kicked off because many will not want to repent. When I prophesied last time about Mendoza, some people thought I was joking, and it happened very fast. Because why? God is not negotiating with anybody.